Hi students, this is T. Balakrishna, Chemistry Lecture, GPT Kottagudem. Today our topic is corrosion, subtopic types of corrosion cells. Three types of galvanic cells are formed during the electrochemical corrosion. They are composition cell, stress cell, concentration cell. First, we discuss about the composition cell or galvanic cell. Composition cell or galvanic cell. A galvanic cell formed between the two dissimilar metals is called composition cell or galvanic cell. If two dissimilar metals are electrically connected and exposed to an electrolyte, a composition cell is formed. In the cell, more reactive metal act as an anode and undergoes corrosion. The less reactive metal act as a cathode. This type of corrosion is called as galvanic corrosion. Students, so this is a composition cell. The cell is formed between the two dissimilar metals. In these two dissimilar metals, it is in a galvanic cell construction. In this galvanic cell construction, two dissimilar metals, one is a zinc, another one is a copper. These two metals are dipped in different electrolytic solutions. Zinc is dipped in zinc sulfate solution. Copper is dipped in copper sulfate solution. These two metals are connected, electrically connected. These two metals are electrically connected and these two metals are exposed to the different electrolyte. Zinc is exposed to the zinc sulfate electrolyte. Copper is connected to the copper sulfate electrolyte. This is a galvanic cell construction. In this galvanic cell construction, when you are construct the galvanic cell, in these two metals, this different composition. One is a zinc composition, another is a copper composition. In these two composition, one composition is act as an anode, another composition is act as a cathode. Is it clear? Here, form a galvanic cell depending upon the composition. So that is called composition cell. Okay. In these two compositions, which metal, which composition is highly reactive, that is act as an anode, which is less reactive, that is act as a cathode. So in these two metals, zinc and copper, zinc is highly reactive than copper. Why it is highly reactive? Zinc is present in higher in the electrochemical series. So the metal which is present in higher in the electrochemical series, that is highly reactive. When you compare these two metals, zinc is present in the electrochemical series higher in the electrochemical series compared to the copper. So zinc is act as a anode, copper is act as a cathode. Students, you remember one simple point is which is act as anode, that is ready to participate in oxidation. Oxidation nothing but corrosion. You remember this point? Oxidation nothing but corrosion. So here zinc is ready to participation in corrosion reaction because there is a highly reactive. Highly reactive metal is act as a anode, that is ready to participate in oxidation reaction, that is also called as corrosion. Here oxidation nothing but corrosion. So in this galvanic cell, when zinc and copper are electrically connected and exposed to the electrolytes, zinc is act as anode, copper is act as a cathode. Since zinc is higher in electrochemical series, so in this cell zinc undergoes corrosion. In these two metals, zinc is ready to undergoes corrosion easily because zinc is highly reactive than copper. So zinc is ready to participate in corrosion reaction. This cell is formed between the two dissimilar metals, dissimilar composition, different composition. So this cell is called composition cell. The which galvanic cell is formed depending upon the composition, such type of cell is called composition cell. You remember every which metal is highly, which composition is highly reactive, that is act as anode, that is ready to participate in oxidation reaction, that is undergoes corrosion. In these two metals, zinc is highly reactive, so it is an act as anode, it undergoes corrosion easily. Next one, stress cell. Next one, stress cell. It is also a galvanic cell. A cell formed between stressed and unstressed parts of the metal is called stress cell. The stressed area in a metal act as an anode and a unstressed part act as a cathode. The stressed parts undergoes corrosion. So in the cell, compared to the before cell, this cell is formed between the different metals, dissimilar metals. But in this cell, the cell is formed between the same metal. In the same metal, the which part is more stressed, that is act as an anode, and less stressed part is act as a cathode. How to explain this one? When we hammer the nail, the head and tail parts of the nail get strained, but middle part of head and tail parts of strained. When we hammer the nail, the head and tail parts are strained, and middle part of the nail unstrained compared to the middle part of the nail. So which is the more strained part? Which is the main part? When we are hammered, the head and strained tail parts are more strained. So the stressed part is act as anode. That means this nail, head and tail parts are act as anode, and middle part of that nail is act as a cathode. So which part is act as anode? That part is ready to participate in oxidation reaction. Oxidation nothing but corrosion. So when you saw this picture, the corrosion is takes place at head and tail part. The middle part is not participating in corrosion reaction. So oxidation takes place at head and tail parts. We take another example, the bent pipe or bended pipes. In this bended pipes or bent pipes, in the bent pipes, the water flow, when the water flows through the bent pipes, the curved parts are stressed and the curved parts are stressed. The curved parts are more stressed than uncurved part of the pipe. So what, when the water is flow through the bent pipes, the curved part is more stressed than the uncurved part. So where the stress part is act as the anode. So oxidation takes place that part. Is it clear? So in this pipe, this part is act as anode because it is a more stressed part. Remaining part are unstressed part. So this part is act as anode, remaining part is act as a cathode. So where the corrosion is takes place, this bended part, this curved part is ready to participate in oxidation reaction because there is a stressed part. So you this galvanic cell is formed between the same metal, but in the same metal, depending upon stress, one part is more stressed, one part is less stressed. Which part is more stressed, that is act as an anode. Which part is less stressed, that is act as a cathode. Take this example, this bent pipe, the bent part is more stressed, remaining part is unstressed. So this bent part is act as anode, remaining part is act as a cathode. So where the oxidation reaction takes place, the bended place, because the bent part is more stressed part, that is act as anode, and oxidation reaction takes place at that part, that is called corrosion. So the anode part is undergoes corrosion. You remember this one, anode part is undergoes corrosion. So anode means oxidation, oxidation means corrosion. That means anodic part is undergoes corrosion easily. Okay, this is a stress cell.